anyways, today is a very special video. I know this video is a tad bit late, but I want to thank all of you guys for 1K. So in my Discord server, I had all of you guys give me some questions, and I will be answering for this 1K Q&A. Stay tuned for the end for a special surprise. I will be doing a little face reveal. Also, I want to give a huge thank you to Public Bathroom for helping me record this video. Honestly, you guys should definitely check out her channel and subscribe. She makes really good content and has great energy in her videos. Venus asked me, what goals will you reach for now that you've hit 1K? Honestly, I think that now that I've hit 1K, I'm gonna really start trying to push out more content videos than just live streams. March Vulture asked, how has your mindset of being a creator changed over time from 0 to 1K subscribers? That's a really good question and a little bit hard to answer. In the beginning, when I first started becoming a content creator, it was a little hard for me to kind of like put my foot through the door and start being more energetic and like being more creative with things. But as I started growing and growing on this channel, I started to have more of these ideas come in. I started collaborating with people, having ideas of like, okay, how can I start bringing more people in and having a bigger audience grow and whatnot. Ian asked me, what made you want to become an Animal Jam creator? I was like, what can I do as my last kind of final thing to do on Animal Jam? Because there's no more updates. The community, even though it's starting to grow now, at the time when I first started streaming, there was hardly people online. So I was like, I guess the last thing I could do is start trying to make content since I hadn't really gone in that territory yet. Russ asked, what's your dream item and what will you do now? So I honestly don't have a dream item. I've never really cared for super rare items. I just care about my den items and den decorating.
My dream item is Red Glass to the Wings.
Mishy asked, who or what got you into Animal Jam and live streaming? What's your favorite thing about it? I will say that Ghosty was a big inspo for live streaming. Vamp asked, how did you decide to start streaming? Were there times when you wanted to quit? So honestly, I never wanted to quit because I never had high expectations that I was gonna get big. It was more so just to mess around and, you know, just keep me busy on Animal Jam so I wouldn't quit the game, because there were so many times where it kept coming across my mind that like, oh my God, I'm gonna quit. How I decided to start streaming, honestly, it just kind of came across my mind one day. Cookie Slug asked, what is your favorite most underrated animal in Animal Jam and favorite pet? Okay, so my favorite underrated animal in Animal Jam, it will always be the hyena. I love hyenas. For favorite pet, I absolutely love the goats and the bats. I think those are my two favorite pets. Venus asked another question, and she asked, are you planning on hosting any possible events in the near future? Art contests, contests in general, or collabs? I'm always open to collabs. I did recently do a collab with Reclu. Shout out to Reclu. Absolutely love them. I always hold art contests in here. I haven't done one in a while because I think I'm not looking for art really, unless it's like stuff within the server, but probably down the road I'll hold more art contests and whatnot. Cookie Slug asks, do you like the new Animal Jam or do you prefer how friendly and less item based it used to be? Honestly, I miss the old days. It was a really fun time with the community because no one really gave a shit about like how rare you were. It was all about, you know, being the community, getting to say hello to Wisteria. I mean, I remember as a kid, I freaked the fuck out when I was able to get into Wisteria's den and she was just breathing. Her pixels were breathing right in front of me. Bloodclaw asked, what do you like better, Animal Jam or Play Wild? Animal Jam, classic all the way. I hate Play Wild with a burning passion. Mossy Fairy asked, how has being a content creator impacted your life, whether it be positive or negative or both? Honestly, I think that ever since I became a content creator, I've always been extremely shy and having a very hard time with talking to people or starting conversation. But with becoming a content creator, you can't be silent on your live streams. Like, you have to keep talking and thinking of things to say. Arbooks asks, what's your favorite thing about streaming? Did you ever think you would make it to 1K? I honestly did not even think I would have a chance to make it past 200 subscribers. Honestly, my favorite thing about streaming is getting to talk to all of the people that I see every time come back to my stream. Luca Fonboy asks, any advice for someone hoping to get back into streaming? I'd say right now is the best time to start streaming now that it's Animal Jam starting to get big again and there's more people coming in. I would certainly suggest making sure you interact with your fans and talk. So Penji Rio asked, how did you come up with your Animal Jam username? So honestly, like, I don't know. I was trying to come up with something really edgy. Graveyard mutt, rancid mutt, rotten fetus, right? And then rotten mutt just kind of like rolled off the tongue. Hate girl 6446 asked, do you like AJ now that the fan base has grown up, or do you miss the goofy childhood feel while playing? I think I love both of it, honestly. Now as an adult, the thing is, like, you can't ever stop, you know, getting older. Granted, I miss the nostalgic times. It's really nice meeting adults the same age as me, because it's like, yeah, we're all traumatized. We all have something in common. We play Animal Jam. Cheese, aka Gino, asked, will you start create content? Yeah, obviously I'm starting to create content, because by the time you guys see this video, that's already content right there. Fluffy asked, are you planning to become a gym bastard? Hell fucking no. Van asked, how long have you been playing Animal Jam for? Did you start playing AJ Classic or Play Wild first? And did you have a favorite Animal Jam YouTuber or gym bastard? So I've been playing Animal Jam since 2011. I did start playing Classic first. For my favorite Animal Jam YouTuber or Gymbassador, when I was a kid, it was Wisteria, but it was also mostly Jillian too. Happy for Tailed asked, if you could only have one clothing item in each category, what items would they be? Oh boy. Honestly, I would have to say everything on my main look. Wolf Hunter asked, if you look back to how you started to where you are now with streaming, what changed? Do you like these changes? Did you think you'd ever reach this far? I absolutely love how just I've started to talk more, because if you go back to like my first few streams, there would be like 10 minutes straight where I'd be silent, not saying anything, or I kept like forgetting to read chat. I'm glad that I've been able to kind of like balance with that. And I do absolutely love these changes. I will say I used to be more raunchy with humor back in my old days, and I've kind of a little dialed back on it. I mean, I do start planning on kind of getting back more into the adult humor. I think I just haven't had that energy lately. Corrupted asked, what do you use for your PNG to make it alive? I use a program called VideoTube, if that's how you pronounce it. June Gloom asked, how did the concept of Void Wolves and or the Void Wolf cult become a thing? So it was my second live stream. There was this really funny joke that happened. So I found this like person that was like advertising their shop, and they were like, oh, mysterious shop, my den. There's totally not a cult in there. So we go into the cult den, and then I was like, wait, chat, we should like dress up as a cult. One of my old moderators, Angel, she goes, oh, we should call the cult like the Void or something. And I was like, that's a good idea. Botch, aka Raiden, asked, how did you come up with your main AJ look, and were the other main looks before? There actually was older main looks I had back then when I was a little bit more broke. I used to have the standard white Arctic Wolf. That was always my thing, except my eye was white, and it was like the default Arctic Wolf eye that you get in the shop. I always wore like the baseball cap, and I had a black worn and then a black short collar and the elf bracelet. So I basically looked like the 2016 fuck boys in the pool room. Also, make sure to like, subscribe, and comment on the video, and also check out Public Bathroom's content. I promise you guys it is worth it. Anyways, thank you for watching the end of the video. Goodbye, guys. Also, rotten mutt jump scare. Smoke weed every day.